I'd like to explain something that you may see in the course of using Pi Process Book or some of the other client tools. Now let's do it like this. I'm going to go ahead and copy this Process Book trend and then paste it and modify it. You may have already noticed what I'm getting after here. Let me modify this, change the background so that this is a clear color. Yeah, there we go. Let me change the trace to a different color so we can tell the difference. And now let me pick it up and move it right on top of the other one. Just a little bit lower. This is a great way to explain this to people who have seen this anomaly at your site. Take a look at the two traces. Even if I put them right on top of each other, they don't align up properly. The blue one, as you can see, has less resolution than the red one. And the reason for that is that the blue trace is showing me exactly what is stored in the archive after our filtering that we call our compression test. And what we're seeing in the red trend is the data that shows up in Process Book in real time as data is coming in from what we call our Pi snapshot. And typically you would see this if you, you know, leave a display alone for a while and then refresh the screen, and then you'll notice that as you leave that alone and don't refresh it, it's getting data straight from the snapshot. Now I'm going to go ahead and show you what typically, how typically people will see this happen. Let me go ahead and delete this, remove this over here. Typically people see this when they come back from lunch or something and they see this trend and then they refresh the screen. I'll go ahead and refresh it now. And all of a sudden, all that resolution goes away. Now here's a view of that same phenomena. And as you can see here, we're seeing a great deal of resolution in this trend. But once you refresh the screen, that resolution appears to go away. And the important thing to notice here is it really doesn't change what you've seen in the trend. The trend is still reporting essentially what happened. What we're doing, though, is instead of storing all this line noise on disk, what we're doing is we're only storing the peaks and valleys. And we do that through this compression algorithm that we are going to discuss presently. Now, if you do find that when you are looking at the raw snapshot data on a trend and then you refresh the screen and you appear to lose resolution, if you actually lose resolution that you can use, there are remedies for that. You can narrow the dead bands that we use in our compression tests so that you're storing on disk more data. But I think everybody would agree in this example, you know, where we have this data that is essentially nothing but line noise, you know, line noise after line noise. Essentially, what you're really interested in capturing here is not the line noise, but just the peaks and valleys. So that would be more like what you're interested in capturing. And in fact, that's what we end up capturing when we store just the peaks and valleys through compression test. So this is our introduction, and we're going to look at the details of both of our tests, the exception test that produces these snapshot values at high resolution that you see right here, and then the compression test that reduces those just to those values that are required in order to store that trend, the essence of that trend on disk.